Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Jinx Lens. This is Ajinkya and today we are going to talk about a book called as Amba, The Question of Red, a novel. Doesn't the name Amba incite certain kind of mythological feel in our mind? I think a lot of South Asians will definitely agree with me, because the way Mahabharata and Ramayana, these epics, are interlinked in our lives that we don't even realize. Whether be it our everyday stories, our stories told by our grandfathers, our parents, etc. And when I came to know that this book has been written by an Indonesian, I decided that I had to read this novel. So without further ado, let's begin our review. Amba is a book published in 2013 in Indonesian by Lakshmi Pamunjak. It was later translated in English by herself, which is the version which I read. This is Lakshmi's debut book, and I feel that as a debut book, she has really done a good job. Lakshmi plays her game of timelines quite well. It is a love story between Amba, a small town girl from Buru Island, and Bhishma, a foreign educated doctor who comes back to Indonesia to practice. So the novel starts in 2011 when Amba is an old woman, then it goes back in time and describes her childhood and her upbringing, Bhishma's childhood and his upbringing. Then it comes a little ahead and talks about the love affair between Amba and Bhishma. But Amba's parents have someone else in her mind, and this is where Salva comes into picture. Salva loves Amba, but when he comes to know about her affair with Bhishma, he also rejects her, just the way it was done in Mahabharata. Amba meets a third man called Adilhard, with whom she marries and remains with him till the time he dies. There are also a lot of other smaller characters like Amba's parents, Bhishma's parents, Samuel and Zulfikar, who help her in the search for Bhishma, and some other smaller characters which help in moving the story ahead and completing all the dots. This is the most simplest explanation of the novel I could give you guys, but obviously it is not that simple. The whole story is described in the backdrop of one of our most violent histories of our times. That is the mass killings of around 1 million people between 1965 and 1968 in Indonesia. The writer has made sure that the love story does not go haywire in the description of the violent communist history. The most fascinating part about this book is taking Mahabharata as an inspiration for the story and putting it in today's time, where all the characters are played by normal people. Through this book, I got to learn a lot about the religious tensions which exist between the various communities in Indonesia. This also reminds me of the fact that how our South Asian countries are different and similar at the same time. One more fascinating aspect about this book is the description of the fact that in spite of being a Muslim majority country and a vast country, they have still kept their Hindu roots alive. How fascinating, isn't it? But I have two small complaints with the book. I don't understand why in every fiction story, the male lead has to follow the typical norms of masculinity. Bhishma has been described as a tall, dark, handsome guy with an amazing body and a lot of female fan following. But it's not necessary that it will be a norm in reality. There are a lot of average men like us who also have a story to tell. So I am talking about inclusivity over here. The second aspect which I found a little bothersome was the detailed and long description of the physical love between Amba and Bhishma. I mean, I get it that they are in love and they are having a good time. But then can we talk about something else also? It was unnecessary to give such detailed description of the love like a Hollywood movie, especially in this context where we have a lot of things to talk about. But apart from these two aspects, this novel gets full marks on all the fronts from me. So I think every one of us should read this beautifully narrated novel, which will definitely grow on you over a period of time. So that was the review, guys. Do let me know in the comment section below how you find this video. Also let me know if you want me to review any other book. And most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, so that you come to know every time I post a new video. I will come up with a new video soon, but by that time, keep reading, keep exploring, and keep inspiring. Bye.